Hello guys, and welcome back to another Secure Kingdoms episode. Today what we are going to be doing is we're going to be trying to build a bridge and work a little bit on the secret project, which is secret, but, you know, secret. So, first thing we're going to do today, though, is probably kill that zombie. Or not, apparently. It's just... really? Why? Oh, I've done a whole bunch of enchanting and combining of picks and stuff, and I've just got a pretty sweet inventory. Other than the bow, which isn't quite perfect. It's got infinity, so that's great, but I need to get that power 5 and flame 1, and I need to fix that diamond axe. That's just fortune 3. But first thing we're going to do is we're going to breed the animals, because, I mean, I run out of food so quickly in this game. I mean, I don't care what it is. It can be steak, it can be mutton, it can be pork, whatever. I just need food. It's just, I use it up. I'll use up a stack in about 5 minutes, pretty much. Like, it's insane. It gets pretty mental after a while. Also, you might be wondering why some of the animals are, like, popping out. That's just because when the babies, they go into the fence and they pop out. It's a pretty normal thing. Kind of annoying. But I kind of like it, because then I have an excuse to kill them and get more food. So, you know, I'm not evil. It's all part of the plan. But, yeah. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to breed these cows, not opening the fence gate. I wonder, should I kill the sheep or should I kill the cows? There is a lot more sheep, but I like killing the cows better. I don't know, I like eating steak more. I said I don't care, but I kind of do. Yeah, that's pretty much all of them bred. Screw it, we'll just kill a bunch. I should probably get looting free on this. Or get a looting free sword so I can actually get way more. There we go. I'm gonna have to move this because this is pretty ugly. Alright, so how much steak do we... Oh, level 30, sweet. You could totally go to an enchantment. Oh, I've got stuck in a bit. Sweet. It's not bad. Good amount of steak. Right, let's put it away. Oh, I didn't pick up any wool. Of course not. Whatever, screw it, I'll fix it later. Put that in there. We'll put that in there, and we'll take the sandstone. Right, so, the bridge that we're going to be building will be over there in the desert, which is why I have the sandstone collected, but let me quickly get this mule I bred, which I've filled up with sandstone as well. I should probably grab some wood, actually, now I think of it, so I can actually do some crafting. Just grab a crafting table, it'll be enough. Right, so the plan that I have here is... my house is right here. It's a pretty big mountain. I kind of claim this kind of entire territory of this mountain stuff. We've got this giant desert in between, but over straight in this direction. I think it's straight, I haven't really ever quite looked at it very well. Yeah, it's right there. That's Portigolo's, like, place. It's got, like, a little mountain and stuff. So what I want to do is I want to connect the two with, like, a giant bridge in the middle, but we would have to decide what... I think that's good. That seems pretty decent. Alright, let me just... Oh god, so slow. Alright, whatever. But that seems pretty in line. Looks, we would have to connect it to there. So what I'm going to do over... Because this one's clearly taller. What I'm going to do is I'm going to run over here. Worst case scenario, we'll just make that mountain a little bit bigger with some stone. Just make a fake mountain to connect the bridge over there. But I feel like that would look pretty sweet. Portigolo did start working on it a little bit, as we saw last episode. And I mean, I'm not really a big fan of it, so I'm gonna go and do my own design, real quick, just to have it something a bit nicer. 86. So let's go 85. 85 is the height that we want to go up to. So it's not really that high, is it? Oh, just stick. Okay, yeah, stack that. Anyway, my idea for it, I'm gonna use sandstone. And I'm going to use the different... First, I'm going to make it out of... I'm going to make one... Like, all right, okay. Anyway, I'll go over here and I'll describe what I mean. Right, my plan is... Let's just use sandstone, I guess. Is make a little cylinder. Let's say that's a little cylinder going up. Then we have the bridge like that going across. And then have a cylinder every so often. And then in between the cylinder, I want to do something. I don't know. I'll do something pretty cool. I might have, like, maybe I could have it so it's a double bridge. Like, one up there, one down here. Maybe, like, the bottom one be filled in with ice so it's a bit quicker. That might be pretty good. Where did that mule go? He's just pissing off, isn't he? But, yeah. So, the cylinders. I'm going to make it all out of... I'm going to make two cylinders today. And I'm going to make it just out of sandstone. And then I might start throwing in some other blocks. Or maybe just throw in the different types of sandstone. Like the smooth sandstone, the chiseled one. I think it would look pretty nice. Because I've got a decent idea in my head. Unfortunately, it would take a lot of sandstone. Meaning I'm going to have to mine out some deserts. What I was doing, the way I got the sandstone before, I didn't really mine out like a desert, like most people do, like when you do the cube. I kind of, there's like little hills in the desert, and I just mined out, I just keep mining them down to like the desert level, so it doesn't look like completely fugly after I'm done with it. Because I mean, you know, it's a nice place when you keep this looking pretty sweet. Minecraft music, I forget how much I hate it sometimes. Whee! There we go. Right, so, we are going to be connecting it there. Let's think about this. Right, if we connect it straight into the middle of that, that would look sweet on my end. How would it look over the... Not... Oh, we would have to... Yeah, we'd have to build it up, or maybe have a staircase that goes down. But I want it to be in line here. Just somewhere right here. Right, okay, let's get you... Like... down here. Even on a bloody donkey, mule, the efficiency. of course, donkey. Not donkey, fucking mule. That's what it is. Not even a donkey. Suck. Anyway. So, we're gonna have to move this as well. We're gonna have to mine it out a bit. But here, so right in line here. So, let's go. Three or five. Let's go with five, like that, and we'll do it like this. This is like just the basic shell. Of course, I'm gonna add some other stuff to it to make it look way better. Because I mean, you know, just having just regular cylinders isn't quite the nicest looking thing in the universe. I don't really build with sandstone much, which is why I'm kind of scared this is gonna go utterly terribly. I've always liked the block. I always thought it looked pretty nice, especially like in the desert. In the desert themes, like some of the things I've seen people do with it, it looks like really nice. It works well with Neverrack, but I not Neverrack, Neverbrick. But I don't really use Neverbrick either, so it's not really. It's just not my type of block. It looks nice. I just don't know how to use it. Just need to learn. Gonna need to try it out. Right. So I've got it here, so how high do we need it to go? What I'm thinking is, instead of having it just a flat way across, right, okay, so obviously the bridge would be across here in line with, actually no, it wouldn't be in line, it would be one more block out, so that's, is that in line? I think it is. And then we'll go one more block out to the side there. Yeah, like that. And then we'll do the same on this side. So this would be the top of the bridge in theory, but what I want to do is I want to make it a bit more rounded at the top. It makes sense in my head. I need to just try and figure out some vocabulary I can use to describe it. Like, right, if I just build this across over here real quick. I don't want it to be flat on the top. I want it to be, like, curved, kind of like a U-shape. Like, right. Oh, just drop down. Oh, do I even have... Oh, I do have the falling boots. Fuck yeah. Totally forgot. Right, so. I want it to go sort of like that but like not as much, maybe something like that. Like just a little tiny U, but then like the path is kind of sunk down a little bit, which would look like nicer from down here, but it wouldn't look quite as nice while running across it. So I need to kind of try and find a way of making it look good on both. I'm gonna work on that, and I'll see you guys in a second. So after a little bit of experimentation, I have came up with this. Don't think it looks the worst. Definitely gonna have to try and round it off a little bit, probably. But this is definitely starting to look pretty nice. Definitely better than, cobblestone. I'm not gonna... Just saying. I think it's looking pretty good. Doesn't seem worse. And then we'll have a couple of these pillars going across. And we'll just have, like, that bit going across. And then we'll do something in between. Not sure. Not really sure if it's... It's a little bit stumpy, is what I'm thinking. I feel like it's a little bit short. Thinking what I could do about that. I could make it higher, but then I would have to build that mountain up over there, like, a lot more. Also, if we... where's the sun at? It's midday. I added a little bit of glowstone up in that little hole behind there, so it might look pretty nice when it's... nighttime. I don't know, not really, haven't really seen it, but yeah, it doesn't look the worst. I think I am gonna have to round something off there. I don't know, this up until that layer there, I'm loving it. I'm loving this little bit as well, but it's a little too diagonal. I feel like if I move that there up, I want to make that stairs. That might look decent, possibly. Now the question is, which one is it? Which one was I looking at? Was it this one? So if I move that there and then change this out to be stairs. Also, we don't want to make this too complicated because, I will need to build a whole bunch of these cylinders going to Bortigolo's house, and I mean, I don't really want to spend 17 years creating every single one of them to look like super OP pan thing. Oh, it's not really... Yeah, I think that looks much better. Actually, does it though? I don't know. Because that was that little cracked layer, which I'm not really a big fan of. Oh, damn it. Wait, is that on smooth? Or is it smooth stone? Is that on it as well? Like, on the underneath? It isn't. I think that's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to replace it with the smooth stuff. How do you even make the smooth stuff? Because I had some, but I've got no clue how you do it. It's like that. There we go. Just make a whole bunch of it real quick. That'll do. Let's get up there and try and change that to be smooth, because I don't know, like, sandstone, it's kind of strange with some of the textures that it's got, especially when you don't quite understand how they form. But yeah, there we go. I think that's gonna look much better. I mean, I know it's not really it seems a little bit plain, but I like that bit of crack there. That looks good. But having a strip of crack there didn't make sense. Yeah, that looks much better. I'm liking that more. Maybe even if I removed that middle stair there, give it a little bit of a more depth. Maybe let's do this side real quick. Get this side going. I've only done this side as well, just to see what it looks like. Just you know, have a nice little gander. Which one was it? Is this the one I'm moving up? Is it? Yeah, it is. So this one moves up. This becomes stairs. There we go. Like that. And then this becomes smooth. I forgot to even run. That was terrible. I was going to try and grab the items there, but apparently not. Not going to happen. Right. How does that look? Yeah. Yeah. Liking it more. Liking it more. Something still seems a little bit off. It might just be because I haven't gotten used to it yet. That might be something that we might want to have a look at real quick. This, if we... I don't want to... Damn it, this is the one problem with having an efficiency 5 pick. If we do that, then change you out to be a stair to the side. Nope, not even gonna go for it. You're gonna ignore it, just completely. That might look better. Oh, how does the glowstone look? Oh, yeah, yeah, that looks pretty sweet. I like the glowstone there. Might make it visible, but I think that looks pretty good by itself like that. Anyway, I'm liking that left side better than that right side. Looks way nicer. One more thing I was gonna try is I was gonna try and put some birch fences into, like, the little middle bit there. Because I think that might look pretty... How do you make the fences again, is it? Ah, it's like that. Just make a couple. Right. I feel like if we put them in here... This would be like adding a whole new colour, basically. Damn it. There we go. Can we... Oh, damn it. Close enough. Try and get it. Nah, not gonna happen. I need a pillar up. Ah! Forgot which thing to use, which, I don't know. I don't really like that. No. Nah, I'm not gonna go with it. Nope. Just gonna keep it like this. Just open. Definitely looks better with just the open. There we go. Yeah, I think that looks decent. I'm starting to like it a little bit more and more. I'm gonna need to fix it on that side as well. So, I'll fix it on this side, and then I'll see you guys at the secret project. Actually, I've changed my mind. We're not going to go to the secret project. We are going to enchant ourselves a pick after I go get the lapis, because I keep forgetting it. But, yeah, we're not going to go show you the secret place. It's secret. Why would I show it to you? No showy. But, so what we're going to do instead for the rest of this episode is we are going to... wish there was a breaking free on that. Would have been great. But no, maybe I'll have an unbreaking free pick. Anyway, nope, definitely not. Apparently I combined them all. Great. But instead what we're going to do is we are going to go and work on a jewel blaze farm, because I have a jewel, like, I found two blaze spawners that were, like, super close to each other. So I'll see you guys there. So we're here at the blaze thing that I'm going to make. Oh great, they do spawn outside here. Great. But this is how awesomely generated this place is. It's great. I bloody love it, because there's one literally right here, and this one is just perfectly in line with it. So my plan is, I'm going to use slime blocks when I eventually get them, because I might possibly not have them yet. And now that I'm saying that, I've just remembered that I forgot to bring something. I'll be right back. Right, I managed to get it. I forgot to bring the 5 slime balls that I do have, because I'm an idiot. Right, so, I do have a design idea for this place. It isn't actually my design. It is a good friend of my design who I asked if I could borrow it into this, and he said yes. And, I mean, I think it looks pretty good. So, that's why I wanted to use it. Because it was sweet. So we'll need some of this. We'll need a whole bunch of cobble. You can make it into stairs as well. So I could start building the design already, but what I first want to do is get rid of those bloody ugly cages and do something with it, right? Obviously. So, how much... Oh, I didn't... don't have much gray glass. I'm going to need to do something with the glass. Right. Now, one thing I do know about blazes is that they can spawn even when the torches are there. The only light level they can't spawn at is the light level produced by a lava bucket. So, in other words, we need to put a lava bucket in there. Let me just quickly mine out the quartz, because quartz is also a part of this build. How many bloody blazes are in there? This is going to be a great blaze farm. Right. It's one dead. Oh wait, they can shoot through that? It's bull. Okay, right. Cut that up. Okay, screw it, I'll just burst through. There we go. Now we'll... Right. If we mine that out like that, and then just... okay, let's think. Damn it, I don't want them spawning. It's getting annoying. Bollocks. Damn it, right, I'll need to do that. Get back up there. Real quick. And then place the lava bucket down and... Yep, they won't be able to spawn. Good. So now I can actually work on this place without having annoying blazes. Oh shit, I'll still have annoying... Wait, what? Did you just spawn? Did that not work? Where am I getting... Oh, it's the ones over there, right? Yeah, they're spawning here still. Why? Okay, maybe it's... different light level? Maybe they were just spawning there because that lava wasn't reaching through the block? I am going to safely assume that is what happened and go with that. One more thing that I just realized that I don't know. How far the blazes can spawn? Okay, well he just spawned right there. This place doesn't seem that dark. What light level is it then? Wait, where's the block light? 14, 13. So we can safely assume that on 12 they can't, but on 11. Apparently, in my head, 11 is the block light that blazes can spawn at. I'm going to be terrified for, like, all the time I'm working here, because I can just hear all the bloody nether noises, and it's horrible. Great. Loving it already. Right, so, block light. I mean, we haven't really seen any of the blazes spawn after I've removed this stuff, apart from that one right there, because, you know, fuck it. And that one right there. God damn it. Right. Okay, let me think. How are they spawning? Okay, so clearly that does not work. The lava thing, just pouring lava over it, doesn't seem to work at all. Can they spawn midair? I need to look into... they can spawn midair. I witnessed it in front of my face. So that's something. God damn it. Hate working in the nether. Sucks. I don't even know how long I've been recording anymore. I had like a stopwatch running, but now I forgot to start it. I'm gonna record for 5 more minutes. That'll probably be enough. But right. Okay, so what if I made a lava flow like that? Huh? Would that... Stop it, please. I beg you. If I made it like that... So that's made it a bit longer. I like how quickly the lava flows in here, though. That's good. Right, so if I make it like that, can any blazes spawn? We'll just stand back a little... Okay, yes they can, in the sky. So that's not good, is it? I would need multiple lava buckets, probably. Okay, so if I got a lava flow going here. Okay, right, so each cage will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 wide. 9 by 9. And then it'll be up there in the height, and then we'll have the lava flow flowing in each corner where this Neverack is. Right, that'll probably work. Probably. Big probably. Now, a question is, how close can we put acacia wood to this fire? Oh, God. Oh, great, he's spawning over here as well. This is bloody painful. I'm hating it. Right, okay. So. For God's sake, I'm gonna just... Might as well just do it like this. Just shouldn't create anything. Just leave it like this, it's fine. They're already spawning enough. Okay. How the frick do I do it? Why am I saying frick? Fuck. Alright. Right, currently, I'm pretty sure they're only spawning in these corners, right? The block light. Block light, where is it again? There it is. 12, 12, 12. Right, so it's just these very corners right here. That's where they're spawning. So if I just fill these out and maybe make the cage a little smaller, I think that'll make the spawn rates a little bit worse. If I am to believe my own head, which, I mean, up until this point it hasn't really worked out. Oh, he spawned like right here, and what block light is that? 11. Right, so I think my theory is correct, that they will be able to spawn. Right, let's try this out in a second. Let's just... Great. There we go. Let's just do that. Well, off to the top. And then block light... 10... 11... Oh, why is it 10 here? What's so different? Oh, right, because I'm not in line with that one. That would probably do it. There we go. Whoa, what? Well, clearly this is not working out. Clearly I'm still wrong somewhere. Where are they spawning? Are they spawning out there? Well, he just died somehow. I don't even know how. Okay. So they're spawning back here. Well, he's... How the... Okay, so they must be spawning outside of this cage over here. So just... Oh my god, this is horrible. I need to bloody look into how far they can spawn away, because that's just getting annoying. But, well, he just spawned right there. So apparently even block light level 12 is... not enough to stop these fuckers from spawning. Jesus, this is horrible. This is going terrible. I'm gonna do this off camera most of it now. This is just so difficult to do. I'm not gonna be able to deal with this. Right, well, I guess I'll see you guys next episode, where I'll show you what I've done with this place, because my ears are already ringing. Well, see you guys next time.